Ladies and gentlemen, from the hit show live from Daryl's house in Hall & Oates, please welcome Eliot Lewis.
Yeah. Is living in the moment, clearly.
We have a few special guests tonight. As you can see, Dee Sawyer on vocals.
Hi, I
and
Miss
Nikki on Where's more cowbell.
I don't even know where the cameras are. I love you all. Hi.
So what's up, guys? Normally I would say good to see everybody. You can't see it, but this place is packed with chairs. Anyway, I hope you're doing good at home, wherever you're watching from, your living room, your couch, your bedroom, your kitchen, your car, maybe jogging. I don't know, wherever you are, I hope you're doing well. And happy to be back here at Daryl's Club. You guys know I've spent a lot of time here since it first opened, really the grand opening to... with Hall & Oates, of course, to, New Year's Eve shows with Daryl Hall, and many, many a solo show. I've kind of lost count at this point, maybe 20 or so. And, of course, we've done maybe half of the Live from Daryl's House episodes here. Right, Pete? I'm thinking maybe 30 to 40 shows here. So it's good. This place kind of feels like home. So good to be here. I hope you're doing well, and hope you enjoy the show. We're going to give you a few minutes of hopefully some musical relief and have some fun, because we need more fun than crazy. So I'm also going to do a couple of different things for you tonight, mix it up a little bit. I'm going to create some songs, so live songs looping. So here's one. Here's something called Crusade. About going through life trying to do the right thing.
Crawling up from below. it takes a crusade, I'm gonna get it done. If it takes a crusade, a minute for the long run. Everyone's on the trip, but got nowhere to go. As they walk
felt good. How's Nikki doing? She's just chilling out, going with the flow.
I don't think she likes it. Like, she needs more cowbell.
She needs more cowbell? Do we have a cowbell for Nikki? All right, so anyway, here's a song. This is a title track off of one of my CDs called Adventure. And I always say, you know, man, you never know what one day is going to bring from the next. Some days are great. You wake up with the best of intentions. And things don't always go according to plan. And this is life. And some years don't work out the way we anticipated, sort of like this year. But we're going to make the best of it because I know something great is going to come out of this situation. So anyway, here's one of my own. This is called Adventure.
Yourself, you
this life may bring. You're too busy looking for something, looking for something that really doesn't matter. Come on! 'Cause it might be good, it might be bad, might be happy, it might be sad, but I know it's gonna be an adventure. It might be high, it might be low, might go fast, it might go slow, but I do know it's gonna be an adventure.
So let's do we'll do a song. I know probably everybody that's watching will know this one. This is a song I would most likely be playing out on the road somewhere with Daryl Hall and John Oates. We would probably be wrapping up our summer tour right about now with a great band called Squeeze and my good friend Katie Tunstall. We managed to get two shows in this year before all this this shit happened, and I always said our last show that we did with Daryl and John was Madison Square Garden. I thought when things got really scary in March, I thought, well, if that's the last show I did, it might as well be Madison Square Garden. But here we are at Daryl's Club, and the music will continue to flow, and so will some Hall & Oates music. I hope you're dancing at home right now and you're living room. We're gonna loop another song here, but first I want to give a good shout out to a very good friend of mine. whose birthday it is today. My good friend Will Smith.
Happy birthday, Will.
Wherever you are, Will.
We love you.
I know we're about the same age, so like happy 40th birthday.
25th. 6th.
No, that's all wrong. I'm 45. So here's a song called, it's called Life Happens, you know.
Oh, this is one of my favorite songs.
Is one of your favorites?
Well, so what happened was, I was on quarantine because of my job.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a healthcare worker, and I couldn't see you. I couldn't see Eliot for like 6 weeks. I was in quarantine, and
that's right.
It was torture.
We were separated.
We were separated by the virus.
But Nikki, although, was not separated.
No,
she
Nikki.
Was with me.
Nikki was with you,
yeah.
Because I didn't want to expose my dog either.
Yeah.
It was a long 6 weeks, and within the 6 weeks of being separated, you managed to put it down into a song of our expression of how we were feeling. You know, like there was nothing we could do. It was out of our control. And this is how life happened.
We'll do that one. I'm going to jump right to that one. It's called When This Is All Over. Instrument change here. So, here it goes. When this is all over. That I'll be kissing you.
missing you in a thousand ways that I've been touching you in a million ways that I've been loving you.
Yeah.
Got me right in my feels.
I gotcha, huh? Well, some songs are just written out of, you know, what you're going through at the moment. That was definitely one. Something the world needs more of. You know this one. How true a lyric.
Waking up in a brand new day. Guess we're heading in a different way. And I tell myself, it'll be all right. We kept way too much inside. Now the truth is so hard to find. And I do what I can to break this great divide. I won't give up the fight. Maybe we could set the world. We won't go quietly. And Nothing wrong with trying to take a stand. Someone else may have a different plan. As we're making our way through the promised land. So I'll offer my hand. Maybe we can set the world on fire. We'll light it up until we all shine brighter. In time we're trying to lift each other higher now. And what we're trying to say, we won't go quietly.
How was that? Are you guys enjoying yourself?
Oh, they're loving it.
All right, well, let's
Can we talk about Nikki for a second here?
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Well, you know, she hears enough music, so she's accustomed to all this. All right, so let's, you know, I like to mix it up and do some of my own stuff and do a couple of songs from, normally when I'm doing my own show, I do a lot of, you know, highlights from Live from Daryl's House, all these episodes that I've done, some of my favorite artists. I'm often asked, you know, what's my favorite episode or my favorite artist that I've worked with, you know, on the show on Live from Daryl's House. And it's almost impossible to say who is my favorite because there's been so many from, you know, the early days of Smokey Robinson, and then, you know, bands like Train and the Goo Goo Dolls and Joe Walsh and Booker T. It's been pretty mind-blowing. But one band that I've been following for a long, long time, since I was a kid, when I was probably 14, I discovered this band called Cheap Trick and fell in love with them. And really, Rick Nielsen, the guitar player of Cheap Trick, really kind of inspired me to I had just picked up the guitar. I had been playing drums up to that point, but he kind of inspired me. I would look at the back of the records and say, see who wrote all the songs, and I realized, well, this goofy guy kind of wrote all these songs, and I thought, if he can do it, maybe I've got a shot. So when Cheap Trick did the episode of Live from Daryl's House here, we were set up here in the round. At some point in the day, I told him that little story, and he was very touched. Him and Robin Zander, the singer, they were a little bit shocked how much history I knew of them, because I have been such a fan. And it was certainly one of the loudest things that I think any of us ever experienced. You were there, by the way, and I believe Rick Nielsen was throwing some picks at you.
I was cleavage catching the picks, just saying.
And he has good aim.
We'll leave it there.
He could snap with his fingers, with his eyes closed behind his back.
So let's, if you don't mind, we'll indulge ourselves here and do a one of my favorite Cheap Trick songs. This is about weird parents. There's probably a whole bunch watching tonight. So this one is called Surrender. We'll be right back.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. No, I think you're weird in a good way. All right, well, we rocked out with that one. Let's take a turn. And we'll go back to the early 70s. So long before I was with Daryl Hall and John Oates, was with this band, great band from Scotland called The Average White Band. And, you know, I grew up listening to the song and playing it in my first band when I was a drummer at about 11 years old. And then fast forward to join the band and then played this song we're going to do for you probably 1,000 times all over the world. And every solo show I've done, I think I've done this song. I kind of reimagined it for guitar because it's a saxophone song. But it's a classic AWB song. I hope you like it. If you've got your dancing shoes on, now is the time to go for it. This is called Pick Up the Pieces. Thank you. Well, thank you, guys. I hope you're enjoying the show. Now, normally when I do my own live streams, you know, I kind of, you know, I play a few songs and then kind of interact and answer some questions. So we're not really doing that tonight, but feel free on the stream, and of course, feel free to share it. And fire away, ask some questions, and tomorrow I'll get to looking at all of them and answer them personally. So, I want to thank you for, you know, not only supporting me over the years, but supporting the club, and it means a lot. So anybody that's bought a ticket or donated for tonight, it is super appreciated, because it will keep an awesome venue like Daryl's House continuing with these live streams, which is important, and hopefully we'll reopen next year, and we'll get back to normal and doing a lot of live performances for you. So here's a song. This is a fun little song, a little more adult-oriented lyric than I normally write. But, you know, it's got to be done sometimes.
What's it about?
It's about you, actually. It's called "I Want to Wear You Like a Tattoo."
Tattoo, just saying.
You do?
I do.
Can you reveal it?
No.
You can't reveal it. Then why even say it?
Well, I hope you guys had a good time. We had a great time. So happy to entertain you for a little while. And again, many thanks for supporting the club here, because this club really, and I've played venues all over the world, and as an artist and as a visitor, it's really one of the best smaller venues I've ever experienced. The sound, the crew, of course, Pete and the staff do an incredible job at everything they do, the visuals, the audio. So please, your continued support is very appreciated. So we'll end with this song. This is it's actually a song I wrote a couple of years ago, but it seems very appropriate now with what we're going through. So I say, take care of yourselves, take care of your health, your loved ones, and be kind to each other, because we are all in this together. We'll be right back. Thank you, guys. We'll see you soon. Stay safe.